based on the car rivalry of Ford and Chevy. I just gotta load my profile real quick. Okay. And you get to play as Ford or Chevy. And obviously those who know me know that I'm a big Chevy fan, so of course I'm gonna pick Chevy. Basically the late 90s to the 2002 Camaro that looked like this. This particular, that had that look particularly of the F-body. We're called a catfish Camaro, which I'm not, I guess because it has a cat looking fish on the bumper, I guess, but I'm not sure. But the car Camaro is the catfish Camaro. I think it's funny, so I just call it that. That's how I designed it. My grandmother used to have a, old Camaro like that, but she had the 2001 Camaro, but it was a V6. I wish she still had it, so I could have reviewed it for you guys for a video. It was a really nice one. It was a nice dark blue like that. It had black leather seats. Oh, it was really, really nice. I used to go all of recreation in that car. It was really fun. Designed it to look like her car. Here's the Cobalt I designed. 2005 Cobalt SS Supercharged Coupe. Obviously, it's a. And then you got the 2005 Impala SS. 2005 Monte Carlo Supercharged SS. And the 2006 Corvette Coupe Z06. Obviously, you have to try to beat the time. And in other races, you have to try to get into first. And of course, you have to get all gold stars in order to advance. And for most races, I got gold. So there's just one race that I'm working on getting gold. It's a bit of a toughie because you have to like rush like crazy just to get gold. But I'm almost there. Last time I played, I was really close to getting gold. And don't worry, I'm still doing that. The poll for the games for the video game playing ASMR. I picked up this game and really thought it would, ASMR Team Chevy would be a good game to review for you guys and show you. That's the look of the catfish Camaro in front. Has that nice Camaro logo on right there. And you just like anything, you just race, you just want to make sure you don't crash. Based off the game's based off that, because you have to try to get to the point without crashing. As you can tell, it's a little hard to control the car and turn sometimes. Especially, I'm not used to the way the game controls. The game works. And the Camaro has handling, but it has a little too much handling. I haven't played it in a few days, so I'm a little bit rusty. Ah, crap. Like I said, yeah. Unfortunately, it shows damage. Yeah, it gets really crazy, like if you crash. And it affects your performance a little bit. The performance of the car if you crash. I usually don't crash like that in this particular race. But I got the camera in front of me, so it's a little distracting, which makes it my driving look a little crappy. But there we go. Just my head a little bit, I can see a little better. Yeah, it's a really fun game though, you know. You just race and everything else, and you gotta race against Ford. Based on the car rivalry of Chevy versus Ford, and obviously those who know me know that I'm going to pick Chevy. Since it comes to Chevy or Ford, I'm definitely Team Chevy. Well, Team Chevy all the way. I love Chevy. It's a really good car, Chevy. And I can show you how you fix the car damage. As money in the game, which I don't know why they don't just consider it cash and points, but okay. And you gotta do a different thing. You wanna do like a drift like that or something to get points, and that's what you're gonna use to buy cars and do repairs on your car. And then I still made it in gold, which that race was pretty easy and simple. No, I don't want to play even again. I have to repair the damage that I accidentally made to the car. I just gotta have some pump plates that are itching like crazy. Anyway. May have time to finish that one race I didn't do. I'm not sure to see. I want to show you guys the upgrades more in the game. I have air induction, AEM, which I think I've installed. Yeah, brute force intake system. RC alloy, which I'm supposed to change the rims, but I don't really see it, so I don't even do it. It seems pointless. It doesn't even change the rims, so what's the point? Brakes, front axle. Some sort of brakes, but somebody's not showing. There it is. CP7040 six piston capilliers, AP Racing, and then the same thing for the rear. And then camshaft, the Performer Plus Cam Series, clutch. Somewhere there is. By AP Racing, the CP. 2000 series and cylinder rods, Holley air system, electronics, Bosch exchange electric control unit, exhaust, definitely Borla, because the Borla exhausts are good even in real life. The Borla exhaust won't add performance to your car. It actually will increase the value of your car. But Borla exhausts are pretty expensive, but they do increase the value of your car, and it's a good thing that you have on a car. A Turbo XL muffler. position. Yeah, look, I forgot to put the best on. It was 6-speed GM ignition control. Should I put the best, the most expensive mods in the game on there, on the car, for the best results? Zoom out a little bit, there you go. Performer RPM manifolds, intake manifold one. Supercharger is a Thunder supercharger system. Suspension, we have the most expensive one. Sportline shock absorbers. Obviously, tires Goodyear, because Goodyear, really good tires. I always put Goodyears on. They're expensive, but they're really good. I mean, I had a Goodyear tire once that lasted like, I think a couple years actually. And that lasted like 2-3 years. And I drove that time, and I drove that car a lot. So, really good tires. You can choose different colors, whichever suits your preference. And the black looks nice, but with the black window tint, it's just too much black. And that's the only complaint about that, is that you can't change the window tint. Not like that person doesn't like, you know, window tint. It just seems tacky. I can understand why you would need a window tint, unless you're a cop or something. Anyway, but yeah. And I'm getting close to where my phone will be recording longer in this video. So, hope you enjoyed this video, Ford vs. Chevy.